Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the graduation mass for the class of 2020. The children will now enter the church. If you can remain seated while that happens. Thank you.
I'd like to acknowledge the Wiradjuri people who are the traditional custodians of this land. I would also like to pay respect for the elders both past and present of the Wiradjuri nation and extend that respect to other Aboriginals present.
I would like to acknowledge our Catholic ancestry, inspired by the light of Christ, with those people who have followed in the steps of Blessed Edmund Rice, Venerable Nana Nagel, Venerable Catherine McCauley, Bishop Gallagher, and Father Jerome Hennessy, with the assistance of laity to spread the word of the gospel throughout the Christian presentation of mercy throughout our region.
Can you please all stand for our entrance hymn? Due to COVID, we ask that you not join in with the singing. Thank you.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ be.
So we gather on this day to thank God for the gift of our ladies and gentlemen whom the Lord has journeyed with, and they have accepted graciously to be accompanied by the spirit-led staff of our school, Hennessy, here to this great day. We celebrate this with thanksgiving in our hearts, with prayerful wishes on this day when we are going through an extraordinary time in our lives. We pray that the gift of today will bring healing, peace, and mercy to Australia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, the Father of every gift, we confess that all we have and are comes from you. Teach us to recognize the effects of your boundless care and to love you with a sincere heart and with all our strength. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Just as a human body, though it is made up of many parts, is a single unit, because of all these parts, though many, make one body, so it is with Christ. In the one Spirit we were all baptized, Jews as well as Greeks, slaves as well as citizens, and one Spirit was given to us all to drink. Nor is the body to be identified with any one of its many parts. If the foot were to say, I am not a hand, and so I do not belong to the body, would that mean that it stopped being part of the body? If your whole body was just one eye, how would you hear anything? If it was just one ear, how would you smell anything? Instead of that, God put all the separate parts into the body on purpose. If all the parts were the same, how could it be a body? As it is, the parts are many, but the body is one. The eye cannot say to the hand, I do not need you, nor can the head say to the feet, I do not need you. What is more, it is precisely the parts of the body that seem to be the weakest which are the indispensable ones. And it is the least honourable parts of the body that we clothe with the greatest care. So our improper parts get decorated in a way that more dignity is given to the parts which are without it, and so that there may not be disagreements inside the body, but that each part may be equally concerned for all the others. If one part is hurt, all parts are hurt with it. If one part is given special honour, all parts enjoy it. Now you together are Christ's body, but each of you is a different part of it. The word of the Lord.
Response. Happy are they who hope in the Lord. Happy indeed is the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor lingers in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of scorners, but whose delight is the law of the Lord, and who ponders his law day and night. He is like a tree that is planted beside the flowing waters, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves shall never fade, and all that he does shall prosper.
Happy are they who hope in the Lord.
Not so are the wicked, not so, for they, like winnowed chaff, shall be driven away by the wind. For the Lord guard the way of the just, but the way of the wicked leads to doom.
Happy are they who hope in the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. I have chosen you for the world, says the Lord, to go and bear fruit that will last. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. A dispute arose also between them about which should be reckoned the greatest. But he said to them, among pagans, it is the kings who lord it over them, and those who have authority over them are given the title benefactor. This must not happen with you. No, the greatest among you must behave as if he were the youngest, and the leader as if he were the one who serves. For who is the greater, the one at table or the one who serves? The one at table, surely. Yet here am I among you as one who serves. The Gospel of the Lord. So we, first of all, thank God for each one of you for having completed your rigorous training to be what you are today. Our thanks also goes to your parents, who out of their many resources or out of their meager resources made sure that they project you in such a way that you are doing us proud today. So thank you, parents. Again, our thanks goes to the community of Hennessy with the leadership of the principal and the staff to make sure that you are what you are today. Our readings are chosen deliberately. And I think in this time that things are very hard, to show what united you will stand and divided you will fall means. I have brought these today for our reflection. This is a broom, isn't it? All right. So, please, can you come forward? Break a piece of it. Yeah, just that. Snap it. Easy. Good. Now stand there. Come. You. Watch it carefully and take your snap. Take a break one piece and do, yeah. See how easy it is, isn't it? Easy, right? Good. Now you come. I want 10 of you to come out. Just 10 of you, randomly. Yeah, but I want you to come, you. Come. 10 of you gather together, bunch up on these and break it. Yeah, just all of you. Please. No. Hold the whole lot of the broom together now. Not one piece by piece. All of you. You including you. All of you. Break. I want you to turn it. No. Yeah. Now, hold it. Hang on. Hold it together like this and snap it. Yeah. Do your best. Get on with it. Why not? All right, it's okay. You're not breaking it. It's stronger than you. All right, thank you so much, guys. You've done well. We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, and we pray that this unity be one and be restored, and they know we are Christians by our love, yes, they know we are Christians by our love. We will walk with each other, we will work hand in hand. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand. And together we spread the news that God is in our land. Let them know we are Christians by your love. By our love, let them know we are Christians by our love. Dear friends, piece by piece, we can see from morning to night and take the broom out, but together, we cannot. You're living as an entity, not as a particle. We are living as a group, not as an individual. You're out to different things in life. Some of you will be Hillary Clinton of Australia. 10 years from now, you will be up and the whole world will hear your fame. Some of you are outgoing to become the next Scott Morrison. Some of you are going to be so great. You will be meeting each other again in the parliament. Think about what you see on the television every day when they meet eye to eye. Individually, they tear themselves apart, but when they are bonded together, they will live. Please always keep the unity together. Now, I have finished my homily, but if you ask me, I will give a little advice. I asked a wise man one day to tell me, and I said, "Sir, in which field could I make a great career?" And you know what he said? He said, with a big, large smile, "Be a good human being. There is a lot of opportunity in this area and very little competition. There is a lot of opportunity in this area and very little competition. Be human, be real, and be a good one indeed." My next advice comes from Obama, and I read this up. I used to follow him a lot. And this strikes me. I want to share these thoughts with you. So he was talking and he said, "Education is not a name of any degree or certificate that can be shown to others as a proof." Is that okay? You're living here, right? Some of you, we are getting out of this place with bright flying colors. In years to come, 4 or 5 years from now, you have your degrees. 6 years from now, you have your master's. 10 years from now, you'll be having your PhD. And he said, it's not a proof of education. Education, according to him, is the name of our attitude, our actions, our language, our behaviors with others in real life, with others in real life. So when you, from today, see Albi, perhaps he becomes an architect, or you see Bridie and he becomes a lawyer, an outstanding barrister, he'll be looking out for some of you and he's doing some great things. Some of you are going to be wonderful farmers. Some of you are on to greater things in life. But what will count is your attitude, your behavior, your language, and your dealings with one another in real life. Because there was a time when all you needed to succeed with was the ability to read and write. And you've got that. After that came the era of university degree. And in fact, you had the chances of getting a good job with a good salary with your university degree. Then there came the era of masters and PhD. So the demands of the labor market went higher. You had to have a master's or a PhD to get a good job. Before long, it became the era of foreign degrees. People have to travel to London, to America, to Harvard. You know, when you say you're from Harvard, it's like, oh, top degree special, you know? So employers started looking for people from foreign universities. Now, dear friends, that era is ending. We are in the era of skills. What you know and what you can do with your brain and with your hands. Your level of education notwithstanding, what matters right now is the skills that you have especially acquired. And that's very important. So I ask you, dear friends, how can you remain relevant in this time of digital age? Work and the terms of work have changed a lot. I reckon, and you can mark this, from 2025 onwards, robots and machines will be doing almost all the works that you will be applying with your PhD, and it's already happening. The Sultan of Brunei and all the other big emirates, they are beginning to import robotic armies, and they are importing robotic bodyguards to guard them. So very soon, policing will be, robots will be doing that. So what are you preparing to do when you leave here? My last advice to you is invest in yourself. Try to upgrade yourself daily, on a daily basis. Do something new with your life and look out for one another. Every day as you go, remember that education is not those badges we carry, certificates and all that. Your attitude, your language, your courage in real life will determine who you are. God bless you, and always learn to walk together, because the light of Christ will shine brighter if you are together always. May we stand and offer our prayers.
Loving God, we pray for the needs of the Universal Church, Pope Francis, Archbishop Christopher Prowse, our parish priests in the region. May they continue in their ministry to guide the Catholic Church and in turn Hennessy students on their journey. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we pray for the leaders in our local community, our college principal, Mrs. Kathy Holding, and the staff of Hennessy Catholic College. May they continue to receive the grace to work with strength and faith. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we pray for all of those affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, whether in the loss of work, health, or loved ones. We also pray for the class of 2020, who have shown strength of character in coping with an unprecedented school year. May their future be happy and successful. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray and thank those families of the Year 12s, the parents and carers that have managed to get their children to school every day and keep up a supportive attitude during the best and worst of times. We acknowledge the families who have come to the end of their journey here at Hennessy. We thank them for their support and endurance. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithfully departed within the Hennessy and wider local community, whom we ourselves have loved, who share in our happiness today, we thank them for the memories they have left us. Lord, hear us.
Loving God, you call each of us day by day to walk with you in trust and openness. Free us from all those things that distract from focusing on you. Help our gentlemen and ladies in their new phase of life. As we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And grant you peace and love all the days of your life. May you experience His peace and joy, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim, saying, you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Christopher, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who are pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. May we stand. Our Father, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace with social distancing in our heart. Turn to one another and you can bow. Peace be with you. Peace. Peace be with you, mate. Good. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
In your packs, Year 12, you have a letter from your parents. If during the song you would like to read that at this time, traditionally this is where you would give your letter to your parents, but as they're with us in spirit, you can read their words instead of being with them.
I see trees of grain, red roses soon. I've seen them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. Brightless day, dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty inside, and on the people gone by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're insane. I love you. My face is crying. Watch them grow. They'll learn so much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Please, may we stand. As we take our worship, praise, and prayer from this place, and into our lives beyond school. May our lives be sustained through the love of our Heavenly Father. May we feel the presence of our Savior walking beside us and know the power of the Spirit in both our actions and our words. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord in your life. Thanks be to God. Have a wonderful day.
seated. Well, congratulations on a beautiful Mass. We now move to the second part of our graduation, which is our awards ceremony and thanks to the college. I'd like to invite Mrs. Kathy Holding to give her principal's address.
Good afternoon, Year 12, Father James, all the parents and carers who I know are following this celebration online, and all the Hennessy staff. I would actually like to begin. I think everyone needs to give everyone a big round of applause. This is the most amazing event, and you all deserve a massive round of applause. You are a very, very special group of people. Challenge accepted. This is the quote Year 12 has chosen for 2020. What an apt quote for this group and for this year. I promise I won't go on and on about COVID, because you see enough about that in the news every night. 2020 has not been the year that any of us would have imagined, and has thrown up many challenges and limitations to how we do things. I still very clearly remember the day in the library when I told Year 12 that they would not be going on the Sydney excursion. The looks on their faces. Is she for real? Who does this new principal think she is? And I was actually wondering who she thought she was too. Who would have known what the year unfolded? This Year 12 group is such an impressive group of young men and women. They are generous, positive, and have a real love of life. They have a talent for getting the most out of any opportunity. The recent Hennessy Day and this week's activities were great examples of this. They enthusiastically involve themselves in these events with so much laughter, full-on participation, and of course, they do love to dress up. I have seen this wonderful group develop resilience and to become hope-filled as the year has unfolded. They have developed an insight into the notion that if life does not quite throw you what you expected, then try another plan. We continually promote the notion that you need to have a plan B in life. In fact, may I suggest you need a plan C and a plan D as well. These students have been very realistic and ready to consider different career paths, university options, and how a gap year might look like. I would like to make special mention to Mrs. Leanne Parkman for her tireless work to know each student and to work with them to develop plans for 2021. Congratulations must go to the families of the class of 2020. The qualities of these students are testament to the caring and supportive homes to which they belong. You must be so proud of your sons and daughters today as they close one chapter in their lives and embark on the next stage of their journey. A major influence on each of you have been your teachers and the staff at Hennessy. The Hennessy staff is caring and professional, and they have worked hard to give you the best possible pastoral and academic experience. Your teachers know you and continually challenge you to be your best. And a special thanks should go to Mrs. McInerney, who has worked tirelessly to support you, guide you, nurture you, and entertain you. I would like to offer you some advice as you begin the next stage in your lives. Do not be afraid to let your light shine and don't let opportunities pass you by. Do not regret. For all of us, there is a risk of choosing the safest paths because of the influence of our peers, the media, our families, but mostly our own fear of failing. Each of us is unique and has special gifts which will make the world a better place. In the words of Nelson Mandela in his inaugural speech, our deepest fear is not that we are weak. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, Who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small does not serve the world. As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. I would hope the education you have received at Hennessy will help you to let your light shine. You have received a sound education in the Catholic faith and have been presented with Christian values which will provide a moral compass for you wherever you go. You have experienced what it is to help others through community service, and you have been given many opportunities to explore and develop your own talents. Year 12, I look forward to you seeing your light shine as you navigate a future of dreams and possibilities. Keep in touch and enjoy the journey into your own amazing lives. God bless.
I'd like to call on Mr. Foraker to announce the first place in subject. If we can just leave our applause to the end of those as well, that would be great. Thank you.
Firstly, I would like to acknowledge the academic award recipients for students who have placed first in their HSC subject. First place in Music 1, Harrison Cleberden. First place in Community and Family Studies, Ella Ronning. First place in Legal Studies, Billy House. First place in Ancient History, English Advanced and Visual Arts, Bridie Minahan. First place in Design and Technology, Nelson Hall. First place in Catholic Studies, Ebony Ulrich. First place in Mathematics Standard 1, Ella Baker. First place in PDHPE, Ellie Silk. First place in Work Studies, Jack Douglas. First place in Biology and Geography, Jada Hall. First place in Industrial Technology Metal, Sid Sell,
First place in Business Studies, History Extension, Modern History, Studies of Religion 1, Shannon O'Brien. First place in physics, Albert Kavanagh. First place in English Standard, Georgina Everdell. First place in chemistry, and Mathematics Standard 2, Jake Sheather. First place in English Studies, Olivia Doolan. First place in Catholic Studies, Angus Brown. First place in Investigating Science, Cara Mooney. I would now like to acknowledge the performance of students who have demonstrated outstanding skills across their VET subject. Attributes include teamwork, a high level of commitment to practical work, examination performance, and consistent application to achieve their competencies. The award for outstanding performance in construction goes to Ryan Lacey. For outstanding performance in primary industries horticulture goes to Jack Douglas. For outstanding performance in sports coaching, the award goes to Declan Cashel. Could we please give all our award recipients a round of applause? We now have the sport award. Mr. Cruz is not in the room. No. We only had one sports award to give out this afternoon, which was the swimming carnival age champions. The open girls champion was Ellie Silk. The open boys champion was Nelson Hall. I would now like to invite Mrs. Sharon Hibbert to the stand to award the KLA Special Awards.
Thank you. I'd just like to ask the KLA leaders to step forward, please. And we can clap after each individual one. These awards will be presented by our KLA leader team. They're presented to students who've excelled in different KLAs. So the first one is our Catherine McCauley Religious Education Award. and this award goes to Sarah Penfold. Our next award is the Joe Watt Trophy for Excellence in English. This will be presented by Ms. Stadmiller, and this award goes to Shannon O'Brien. Our next award is the Edmund Rice Mathematics Award, presented by Ms. Carberry. This award goes to Georgina Everdell. The Darren Rose Memorial Prize for Science is donated by the Rose family. This year it will be presented by Ms. Keith. And this year the recipient is Albert Kavanagh. Our next award is the Alex Walk Hissey Award, presented by Ms. Jaspreza. This year, the recipient is Bridget Summerfield. Our next award is the Charles Sturt PDHP Award, which will be presented by Mrs. McCann. This year, the award goes to Ella Ronning. Our next two awards will be presented by Mr. Schmidt. The first one is the William Lynch Vocational Education Award, which is given to a Year 12 student undertaking a VET course who demonstrates dedication and development of their skills. Congratulations this year goes to Ethan Newham. Our second award in this category is the Nancy Walk Memorial Award. It is presented to an individual demonstrating practical excellence in hospitality. This year, the recipient is Jack Douglas. Jack's very happy. Jack, you might need to do that for the camera again. It's a bit of a victory sign. Our last two awards will be presented by Mrs. Marianne McLaughlin. The first one is the Class of 67 Music Award, and this year the recipient is Harrison Cleverdon. Our last of our KLA awards is the Morris West Award for Creative Endeavours, and goes to a student who produces an outstanding major work. This year, the recipient of this award is Bridget Summerfield. So congratulations goes to all of our KLA Special Award recipients. I'd like to now call on Mr. Mark Chifley to announce our special awards.
It gives me great pleasure to announce the special awards this year. Year 12 Class of 2009 Get It Amongst Award will be presented by Albie Kavanagh. The award is presented to a student who has been active in college events, taken all opportunities given to them, and has demonstrated school spirit. This year's recipient is Ellie Sabadusi. The Sister Philomena Sewell Award will be presented by Ms. Carolyn Devlin. These awards are for students who have shown consistent application to academic pursuits, demonstrated growth, displayed perseverance, and performed to their best. The recipients this year are Ella Ronning, Olivia Doolan, Jake Sheather, and Emily Ulrich. The Nano Nagel Community Service Award will be presented by Ms. Jess McInerney. This award is presented to students who have committed themselves to student leadership, who engages in a number of community services, activities, and demonstrates a commitment to social justice. The recipients this year are Bridie Monaghan, and Ellie Sabadusi. The Courtney Thompson Individual Achievement Award will be presented by Max Tin. Donated by the Thompson family in the memory of their daughter Courtney, the award is presented to the student who has persevered to overcome adversity. This year's recipient is Grace Corkill. The Nicholas Dewar Memorial Endeavour Award, represented by Ms. Kathy Holding. Donated by the class of 2017 in memory of one of their classmates, Nicholas, this award is presented to a student in Year 12 for consistent effort and application over the senior years of studies. Additionally, the student demonstrates accomplishment in co-curricular pursuits. The recipient this year is Shannon O'Brien. The final award is the Australian Defence Force Academy Long Tan Award for Youth Leadership. This will also be presented by Ms. Holding. This award is presented to a student who displays youth leadership and will officially be presented to the college presentation evening in Term 4. However, today I can announce that the recipient will be Ella Murphy. Now call on Ms. Hibbert to present the Academic Excellence Awards.
It's my great pleasure to award to announce our Academic Excellence Award recipients. These students have demonstrated excellent academic achievement across a range of subjects. So we'll just keep our applause to the end. Albert Kavanagh. Georgina Everdell. Jada Hall. Bridie Monaghan. Shannon O'Brien. Sarah Penfold. Ella Ronning. Jake Sheather. Ellie Silk. And Ebony Ulrich. Congratulations again to everyone. I'd now like to ask Mrs. Jessica McInerney to come up, please.
Can I please bring up the Gallagher House leader, Mr. Luke Miller? Mr. Miller will announce the Gallagher House and Mrs. Holding will present the students.
It's my great pleasure to present to you the graduating students from Gallagher House. Albert Kavanagh. Harrison Cleverdon. Grace Corkill. Olivia Doolan. Georgina Everdell. Samuel Falcon. Talia Hoskins. In his absence, Angus Jones. Chloe Madgwick. Bronte Mutin. Bridie Minahan. Ella Murphy. Zachary Summer. Luke Tierney. Congratulations to our graduating Gallagher students. And I invite Mrs. Georgia McGrath to present the Macaulay students.
Congratulations to the following students from Macaulay House. Sophia Albino. Azaria Arthur. Angus Brown. Declan Cashel. Brock Davis. Zachariah Downey. Shay Grosvenor Peters. Billy House. Rosemary Irving. Emily Lindsay. Charlie Madden. Shannon O'Brien. Aidan Pratt. Ellie Sabadusi. Marnie Schiller. Ellie Silk. Jason Smith. Thomas Telfer.
Max Tiernan. And Ebony Ulrich. Please congratulate the students of Macaulay House. I would now like to call upon Miss Emily Nowlin to present the Nagel House Awards.
I'd like to congratulate the following Nagel students: Acacia Blom, Hallie Betts, Shamley Devi, Lachlan Fraser, Henry Grace, Campbell Harden, Cara Mooney, Ethan Newham, Cooper Powderly, Paige Van Ryswick, Sid Sell, Jake Sheather, Aubrey Joy Steed, Bridget Summerfield, and Molly Thackeray. Congratulations, Nagel 2020. I'd now like to invite up Miss Mary Louise Payne for Rice.
It is my honour to announce the Rice students. Ella Baker. Annabelle Binney. Taylor Dickinson. Jack Douglas. Jada Hall. Nelson Hall. Nicholas Jenkins. Ryan Lacey. Hannah Mooney. Elizabeth Nowlin. Sarah Penfold. Ella Ronning. And Sean Tickner. Please join me in congratulating the Rice 2020 students. I'd like to now pass it over to Mrs. Jessica McInerney.
I'd like to now hand some gifts over to the college on behalf of the Year 12 students. Can Bronte Mutin and Georgina Everdale please come forward, and Mrs. Holding accept a gift on behalf of the college for the staff. This year, they'll be presenting a coffee machine to the Hennessy staff.
You can't go wrong with coffee, can you?
Thank you, guys. I'd like to call upon Hannah Mooney to present a gift to Mrs. Holding, our college principal. On behalf of the Year 12s, Mrs. Holding, thank you for the most exciting year. We will now make a presentation to the student leadership team. Mrs. Holding will present. The Gallagher House Captains. Bronte Mutin, and Zachariah Summer. Our Macaulay House Captains, Max Tienen and Ellie Sabadusi. Our Nagel House Captains, Cara Mooney and Sid Sell. Our Rice House Captains, Sarah Penfold and Hannah Mooney. And to our college captains of 2020, Bridie Marnahan and Albert Kavanagh, Mrs. Holding will now present you a gift as the outgoing captains. Bridie, you can have your badge back.
Finishing school is one of those moments in life that is so exciting and yet daunting. To have reached this important milestone is a wonderful achievement, and you all should be incredibly proud of yourselves as you head into your final exams and look to life beyond school. Whatever your plans may be, go forward confidently, knowing that your family, your school, and your local community wish you every success.
Would now like to call upon Bridie and Albie to address Year 12.
So, we thought we'd like to wrap up our schooling with how it all started, by sharing our ABCs and going through some memories that go with that at Hennessy Catholic College. So A is for the athletics carnivals that have been a great opportunity for the sporty kids to showcase their talents. The most recent one obviously didn't happen, but we did our best to improvise. B is for the basketball competitions that brought out the competitive side of Year 12s as we watched Mr. Quinn taste the dirt in front of everyone. C is for coronavirus, a disease that has turned the world upside down and made our Year 12 experience very unique. Here we are, spread out and talking to our parents through a camera. D is a throwback to the Year 11 dead ball. Despite the great choreography, the dancing skills were still questionable. E is for excursions. Big Splash, Wambaroo, Canberra, and of course, the excursion that shall not be named. Many of these excursions included some interesting harnesses. F is for footy. The endless amounts of touch, rugby union, rugby league, and league tag that we've been involved with, as well as the McLean Cup, with what some would call a healthy amount of rivalry. G is for going, going, gone. We recognise those who have left us and move into the workforce, such as Bailey working for Allied Grain and Caitlin's hairdressing. H is for highlighting, something we're yet to realise doesn't magically help you remember things while studying. I is for integrated PC classes, a new system that we have been lucky enough to experience since Year 10, including plenty of sporting challenges, Connect Four, you know, and much more. J is for just put your phone up the front, Fraser. I'm not asking again. K is for Mount Kosciuszko. a trip that the geography class was lucky enough to go on, and what I'm told was an awesome experience. L is for the library, a place where we had our most productive chats and probably our least productive study. M is for the misses, the misters, the misses, and the misses. The teachers that guided us through the schooling experience, who we are truly grateful for.
N is for the new additions. Life has become infinitely more interesting with our Kuna students joining us in year 11. P is for our parents, the amazing people that provide an unconditional support network for us every minute of every day, and of course working overtime during exams to keep us from completely flipping out. Q is from quitting in a fit of rage, which is one of our favourite things to do. But we push through, making the best out of every situation and accepting every challenge thrown at us. R is for the two R's of schooling, reading and writing, or maybe not so much. S is sliding around the oval in tractor tubes in the famous race on Melbourne Cup Day. We're not sure how we got away with doing this legally, but it's definitely something that we won't forget. T is for the trip to Cambodia, which was an immersive experience where we gained insight into the lives of the less fortunate, as well as the taste of a raw fertilised duck egg, as I'm sure Sarah and Cara would remember. U is underestimating the effectiveness of a last-minute cram session before exams. V is for virtual learning, attending Zooms from the comfort of our own homes, often our own beds, lounge rooms, or even the back of Jason and Ryan's utes. W is for white shirts, an automatic indication of privilege within the school, yet our parents' biggest fear. X. No one knows what X is because our year is pretty woeful at maths. Well, at least 80% are. 80% are, but the other 25% do all right. Y is for YouTube, a helpful study tool or a destructive procrastination tool. Especially Max watching his bowling videos in study. And finally, Z is for Zarizut, a Hebrew word meaning zeal, enthusiasm, eagerness to serve, and passion, traits that we have all embodied throughout the past 6 years and through our whole schooling experience. Our motto this year has been challenge accepted, and boy, have we all lived up to that. No matter what has been thrown at us, we have overcome it as one. And for that, we are so, so proud. We would like to thank everyone involved in this journey, teachers, students, and parents that have gotten us this far. So to sum it up, we hope you all never forget your ABCs. But more importantly, we hope you never forget one another and the memories we have made in this crazy, wonderful experience together. The last thing we will say is that whatever you do in life, do it confidently and do it as yourself. There is no script. Live your life and soak it all in. Thank you.
Okay, it gives me great pleasure now to dismiss the Year 12s for the final time. Can I ask all the staff to move outside to join the Guard of Honour and the Year 11s? Year 12s, just remain where you are for a minute, please. While we've got Miss McInerney here, I think we'd all like to put our hands together and congratulate her on the wonderful job she did after you guys. Year 12, class 2020 and 20, COVID-19, gives me great pleasure to dismiss you for the final time. Please follow Miss McInerney out.
Done.
inside and out, and love strange, surreal in the dark. Think of the tender things that we were working on. Slow change may pull us apart. When a life gets in your heart, baby, don't you forget about me. Don't you forget about me.